Hello friends, in this video let me explain what is personalized visual and what enhancements we have got in October 2020 update with regard to personalized visual. Personalized visual feature introduced in May 2020 update, where it gives extra capability to the end users. When you publish this report to your recipients, they will be able to change the chart the way they want. So let us understand what exactly that feature was, and then we'll understand what happened in October 2020 update. If you look at this report and each visual, they have got only two icons mainly. One is filter and focus mode, and then more options where they can do the ascending descending sort and sort by any specific field. And when you publish this report, based on the preferences you set for the users, they will be able to access these options. But when they wanted to change this visual at their own end, and they wanted to change this column chart to pie chart, some other chart, and they wanted to see how it is looking like, they will not be able to do. Before May 2020, they're supposed to call the developer, they give the requirement, so the developer will do the requirement changes, do the changes, and then share the report with them again. So this personalized visual option will give the user to do the changes at their own. So what are those changes and how to activate it? As a developer, you don't want to give this option to everybody. Maybe for few users, you don't want to give it. And till September 2020, this was based on each visual. And then first you need to actually set up this personalized visual option in the backstage, that is options and settings. So let me show you where that option is. If I go to file, and then if I go to options and settings and options, there in the current file section, I have an option reporting, report settings rather. There, personalized visuals, allow report readers to personalize visuals to suit their needs. If you activate it, now you will see one extra button at each visual. That means this visual can be personalized by the report reader. But in this case, I've already set not to personalize. That means this individual chart I want to keep as it is, and the end user also should see this as it is only, no changes required. So what I did, so till September 2020, what you're supposed to do, what you are doing, if at all you are using personalized visuals, you are actually going to selecting each visual and then go to the formatting options, the properties, and if you scroll down, you will find an option visual header. Under visual header, if you expand it, you'll be getting that option in the very down, personalized visual. Currently I made it off. That is the reason this particular chart or visual is not having that icon. So let me make it on. Now you can see that icon is available. That means when you publish this report to the end users, they will be able to visualize this the way they want. After October 2020 update, if you wanted to give access to the end user to personalize each visual, that means all the charts or all the visuals on this page or on this report, now you need not select one by one and do it, whatever I've shown earlier. You can simply unselect every chart and then just go to the page properties. There you can activate it, personalize visuals at a report level. So if I just say on, everywhere will be available. If I say off, all the visuals will be losing that capability. So let me say on, and now let me publish this visual, and then when you share that report with somebody, what they will be able to do it. Let us see that. First, let me save the file. And then if you see the publish button, it is new button because I'm using October 2020 update. And then if I click on publish, so now you can search the destination, the workspace, with a search box. You can type the name. Earlier it was not there. I think it was introduced in September 2020 update. Before that, you need to scroll down to select. And if you have many workspaces, obviously that was not a good thing to do. but this search option is now makes things much better, so that you can just type whatever, for example, I wanted to access some Accenture training. If I say yes, I can select that. Now it is getting published to that particular workspace. Once it is published, I'll get a link, so that if I click on the link, I'll be getting into a service. I'm just clicking on this. And now let us see what exactly happens. What is personalized visual? Let us see. For that, let me go to the visual. In the visual, you can see that button is appearing now. So now when you share with somebody also, the same interface will be there. There I'm selecting personalized visual. Now you have a proper window opened up. There, I don't want this clustered bar chart. I want this maybe clustered column chart. I don't want this to be by country, but this I want to see by product. And maybe you can add gross sales. So instead of gross sales, you can add sales. And then let me add one more field, cost of goods sold. That means I will be able to change it. That means your end user, your customer, will be able to see all the changes by themselves without disturbing you. And then you can add a tooltip also, so that their internal requirement they can accordingly fulfill. I hope you have understood what is personalized visual, and this feature is very useful. You must try, and if you have any questions, please mention them in the comment section. To get further updates on my videos, please do subscribe if you have not yet subscribed, and if you have already subscribed, thank you very much.